Hello students, I'm Sai Baba here. So in my previous class I have discussed the problem 7 which is shown on the screen now. I have also discussed the first part of the problem 8. Of course I have explained the second part of the problem 8, but I would like to again discuss the second part of the problem 8. So you can see here, again we'll read that both the questions. One, say 1 kg mass stretches an ideal spring by 0.8 meter in equilibrium position. It is further pulled down by another 0.05 meters in release. Then it oscillates with the time period. So as I explained earlier, the amplitude of oscillation will be 0.08 meters. I'm sorry, 0.05 meters. The amplitude of oscillation will be 0.05 meters. So, in the question number 8, I have already discussed the first part of the question. I was discussing the second part of the question. Explain the procedure, but I would like to again discuss second part. So based on the problem number 7, we have seen that again reminding here time period of oscillation 2.2 xe by g, x is elongation of the spring in equilibrium position of the mass, which is equal to 0.8 meters . So this comes out to be, as I discussed in the previous class, I have just repeating this first part of the calculation. You'll get 4 pi by 7 seconds, that you can write 2 pi by omega. So omega we got 7 by 2 per second, and the amplitude of oscillations, as I explained in the previous class, is 0.05 meters or 5 centimeters. So you are asked to find the second part of the question, the speed of the block, second part of problem 8. You have to find the speed of the block when at the instant when the spring is stretched by 0.825 meters from its natural length. So let L naught denote the natural length of the spring. That is the length of spring when it is neither stretched nor compressed, when there is no elongation. And x is elongation of spring in the equilibrium position of the mass. So this equilibrium position can also be considered as the mean position for oscillations. The block is further pulled down below this equilibrium position and by 0.05 meters or 5 centimeters in release. So that will be the amplitude of oscillations. So the lowest position for oscillations is at a distance of 5 centimeters below the mean position or equilibrium position. Elongation of the equilibrium position is 0.8 meters. Along with the spring in the equilibrium position of the mass. So in the speed of the block at the instant when the spring is elongated by 0.825 meters. To find the speed of the block at any instant, you have to know the displacement of the block from equilibrium position. So displacement when the block, when the spring is elongated by, at the instant when the spring is stretched by 0.825 meters, the displacement from mean position or equilibrium position is denoted by x. That means that the instant when the spring has elongation of 0.825 meters from its natural length, let x denote the elongation. So from the figure you can observe elongation in the equilibrium position is 0.8 meter plus x can be written as 0.825 meter. That means you have to find the speed of the block at the instant when x equal to 0.825 minus 0.8 meter or 0.025 meter, or if you convert into centimeter, you have to find the speed of the block at the instant when x equal to 2.5 centimeters. So you can use the equation v equal omega into, I mean, magnitude velocity of the block at the instant in the block, what is the distance x from the equilibrium position or mean position, is given by v equal omega into root of a square plus x square. Can substitute omega equal 7/2 per second and amplitude a equal 5 centimeters and x equal to 0.5 centimeters. Come on, those who want to copy the working again, they can take a pause and copy the working. And also try, they should try to complete the simplification part in case you have not completed it in my earlier class. So if you simplify this, you get the answer as 35 into root 3/4 centimeter per second. If you want to copy this, you can take a pause and copy this problem. I mean, copy the solution of the problem. So next I am going to discuss some special cases in the electrical oscillations of a mass suspended by spring. So after you have finished working of this problem, you can stop writing. So next you just concentrate only to listen to my explanation or discussion. So I will be showing the notes for all the special cases which I am going to discuss one by one for you later. But you initially first concentrate only to listen to my discussion. Don't try to write the running notes when I am explaining these special cases. So I am next going to discuss the special cases in vertical oscillation mass attached to the spring. I will be discussing the first special case, which is sometimes called as impact loading. We find number of questions based on this case in the past entrance exam papers. Let us consider elastic ideal spring of force constant K, whose upper end is fixed to a rigid support. The upper end of the spring is connected to a rigid support, and let L naught denote the natural length of the spring, that is the length of spring when it is unstretched and uncompressed. Now let us suppose a block of mass M is attached to the lower end of spring and the block is released from rest with the spring unstretched. That means initially the block begins to start moving under influence of gravity, because initially the spring is unstretched, so elastic force by spring is zero in the initial position of the block. So the block is dropped or released from rest, of course, by attaching, the block is just attached to the lower end of spring and the spring is initial unstretched, the block is released from rest with the spring unstretched. I am going to discuss on how to find The maximum elongation spring from its natural length and the amplitude of oscillations. So the velocity of the block is zero in the initial position. So that can be considered as one of the extreme positions for oscillations. Velocity of the block again becomes zero at the lowest position. That is at the instant the spring has maximum elongation. So we assume that the maximum elongation of spring in this case is within the elastic limit such that the spring obeys Hooke's law throughout the oscillations. So let X subscript M denote the maximum elongation of spring from its natural length. You can find the maximum elongation of spring from its natural length in terms of the weight of the block and elastic force constraint K by using the conservation of mechanical energy. Here the block oscillates vertically up and down under the action of the two forces. One is its weight mg, which is the gravitational force of the block by the arc. The second one is elastic force by the spring. Both these forces are conservative forces. Therefore, total mechanical energy of the spring mass system remains constant during the oscillations in the absence of air resistance and non-conservative forces. In the absence of air resistance and non-conservative forces, total mechanical energy of the system remains constant. So, total mechanical energy of the system of the block and spring at the lowest position please try to concentrate only to listen to my explanation. Don't write running notes when I am discussing. I will show you the notes, the printed form or typed form of the notes with PowerPoint presentation after my discussion is completed, after my explanation is completed. TMEM is total mechanical energy of the system of the block and spring at the lowest position is equal to total mechanical energy of the system of the block and spring at initial position. So total mechanical system of the block and spring, as I discussed once in the past in work power energy, I have discussed similar situation earlier in work power energy. So when you consider block and spring together as one system, then the total mechanical energy of system is sum of three terms: kinetic energy of the block plus gravitational potential energy of the block plus elastic potential energy stored in the spring. So at the lowest position, velocity of the block is zero, kinetic energy of the block is zero. I choose the lowest position of the block as a reference position for measurement of gravitational potential energy. That means I will assume that the gravitational potential of the block to be zero at the lowest position. So elastic potential energy stored in spring is maximum at the lowest position because elongation of spring is maximum. So elastic potential energy stored in the spring at any instant is given by U equal to half kx square, where k is elastic force constant of spring, x is elongation spring from its natural length. So at the lowest position, this elongation from natural length is maximum. This maximum elongation I have denoted by x subscript m. Now again, total mechanical energy at the initial position, that is when the spring is unstretched. Sum of three terms, kinetic energy of block is zero at the initial position. Gravitational potential of the block at the initial position can be done mg into initial height of the block above the reference position. Elastic potential energy stored in spring can be taken as zero at the initial moment when the spring is unstretched, unstrained. So you can write the initial height of the block above the lowest position. Same as the maximum elongation of the spring from its natural length. So you can substitute HI equal XM on the right hand side. So half K XM square equal MG into XM. So you get XM square by XM is equal to MG by K. So maximum elongation of the spring from its natural length before the block momentarily stops will be 2 mg by k. Of course, the block does not stop at the lowest position. The maximum elongation of spring within the elastic limit, and there are no air resistance in the case of undamped oscillations. After reaching the lowest position, the block starts moving upwards because at the lowest position, the magnetic elastic force by spring exceeds the weight mg of the block. At the mean position or equilibrium position, the magnet of elastic force exerted by the spring on the block will be equal to the weight mg magnitude. So that net force of the block will be zero. That means the block is moving downwards at any instant. Two forces are acting on the block. One is its weight mg, which acts vertically downwards. I mean gravitational force of the block by that. Second one is elastic force by spring. If the longer the spring is downwards, the elastic force by spring acts upwards. So at the equilibrium position, the net force is zero. The resultant force is zero. Therefore, at equilibrium position of the block, the net force of the block is zero. So magnetic elastic force by spring can write K into XE. It will be same as the magnet of its weight mg. KXE equal mg in magnitude. So elongation of spring in equilibrium position is equal to mg by k. The equilibrium position can be considered the mean position for oscillations. The magnitude of the displacement amplitude denoted by capital A is equal to the distance between the equilibrium position of the block and one of the extreme positions. So you can observe from the figure the maximum elongation of spring from natural length can be written as sum of the magnitude of displacement amplitude and elongation of spring in the equilibrium position of the block. So therefore, the amplitude of oscillations, I mean magnitude of displacement amplitude, maximum elongation of spring minus x, that will be 2 mg by k minus mg by k, which is again equal to mg by k. You can observe that the amplitude of oscillations is equal to mg by k, which is same as elongation of spring in the equilibrium position of the block. That means you compare this equation and this equation. You can observe that in this case xe equal to a equal to mg by k. That is only a special case, not general case. The magnitude elongation is double the elongation equilibrium position, or two times the magnitude of the displacement amplitude. Sometimes you may be asked, what is the maximum acceleration of the block during oscillations? So the acceleration of the block is maximum at the lowest position. That you can find by omega square root k. Or the weight mg of the block acts downwards at all instants. At the lowest position, the magnetic elastic force by spring on the block will be equal to k into xm. So, at lowest position, you can write magnitude of net force equal to kxm minus mg. I mean at lowest position. That is called mass into magnitude of acceleration at the light speed. Magnitude of acceleration maximum at the light speed. Then substitute xm equal to 2mg by k here. You substitute xm equal to 2mg by k or kxm equal to 2mg. That comes out to be magnitude of the maximum acceleration during the oscillation, same as the magnitude of acceleration due to gravity. So I will first, again I will show you the summary of the discussion I have just done for case 1. That means I will be showing the notes for case 1 in a systematic way. I will be first showing you the conclusion. Later I will show you the working for the conclusion. And those who are writing the notes, please get ready with your notebook and pen. So look at the screen here, special cases in vertical oscillations. Case 1 impact loading, that means the same case which I have just discussed now. I will be first reading the conclusion which is shown on the screen. Later I will be showing you the working for this conclusion. Consider an ideal elastic vertical spring with its upper end fixed and a mass capital M is attached to the lower end of spring, which oscillates vertically such that the spring is unstretched at the highest position. Then the displacement amplitude will be same as elongation in the equilibrium position. That means I have directly given you the conclusion straight away here, which I already explained before. If you want to copy this conclusion, you can take a pause and copy the conclusion. So next I am going to show you the working for this conclusion. So now I am showing the working for the conclusion I have directly shown you. This is the diagram. You can look at the diagram on the screen. And those who are writing the notes, please copy this diagram in your regular class notes. I advise every student to write the notes. Here L0 represents the natural length of spring. The block has no velocity at the highest position during the oscillations. At the highest position during the oscillation, the spring is unstretched. Or you can say the block is released from rest when the spring is unstretched. And XE represents the elongation of spring in the equilibrium position of the block. And XM represents the maximum elongation of spring. And here I have shown the lowest position of the block where velocity again becomes zero. Position the block where the velocity becomes zero, and distance between one of the extreme position to the other extreme position, that means distance from here to here, will be 2 times the magnitude of the displacement amplitude. So now look at the screen for the working, the same working which I explained before this. Now we can start writing. TME means total mechanical energy of the system of the block and spring in unstretched state is equal to total mechanical of the system at the lowest position of the block. This is equal to total mechanical, as I already explained this working. The initial height of the block above the lowest position is denoted by H1, which is equal to XM here. The lowest position gravitational potential is taken as zero. Kinetic energy is zero at both the positions shown in the figure, at the highest position as well as at the lowest position. The same working which I explained now, I have shown on the screen. Those who are writing the notes, please take a pause and finish writing the notes up to here, so that I would like to show the notes for continuation to this. So next I am going to show the notes continuation of this. Xm equal to mg by k or xm equal to 2xe. Here 2a equal to xe or a equal to xe equal mg by k. Xe is the elongation of spring, the equilibrium position of the block. Come on, Those who are writing the notes, they can take a pause and finish writing the notes. So next I am going to discuss case 2. Again, you after completing work, copying the working for case 1, please again stop writing. Again, listen to my explanation for case 2. Later I will show you the notes for case 2. Now those who are writing the note, they can write the notes later. So I am going to discuss the second special case in vertical oscillations of a mass attached to spring. Let us consider a spring vertical elastic spring with force constant K, whose upper end is fixed to a rigid support. And there are two blocks of masses M1 and M2 attached to the lower end of spring, and system of the two blocks and spring is at rest originally. Now the second mass M2 is gently removed from one side without disturbing the remaining system. Then you can be asked to find the amplitude of oscillations and time period of oscillations for the remaining mass, that is the per mass M1 after M2 is removed. You find number of questions in all standard books and previous exam papers based on these special cases. So if you want to discuss these special cases before you practice the problem, then you can approach the problem with more confidence. Let L0 denote the length of the spring when it is unstretched. And let X1 denote the elongation of the spring from its natural length in the equilibrium of the first mass M1. Let L0 denote the length of spring when it is unstretched, or natural length of spring. Let X1 denote the elongation of spring in the equilibrium position of the mass M1. So equilibrium position of mass M1 means some students mistake it as the position where velocity of M1 is 0. Equilibrium position of the mass M1 means it is the position of the mass M1 at which the resultant force on the mass M1 becomes 0. So in this figure on the left side, I have shown the equilibrium. Please concentrate to listen. Don't write running notes. I will show the notes separately for you. This is the equilibrium position of the total mass of the system, M1 plus M2. So that means let X2 denote the elongation of spring from its natural length in the equilibrium position of total mass M1 plus M2. That means originally the two masses are hanging from lower end of the spring and system is at rest, not oscillating, in the equilibrium position of the total mass M1 plus M2. Now the second mass M2 gently removed from one side Next, I would like to, then the mass M1 starts moving upwards. So in the equilibrium position, net force is zero. So in the equilibrium position of the mass M1, resultant force on M1 is zero. That means the magnitude of the elastic force by spring K into X1 will be same as the magnitude of its weight M1G. You can write K into X1 equal to M1. K is elastic force constant in magnitude. So elongation spring from its equilibrium position, elongation spring from its natural length, in the equilibrium position of mass M1 is M1G by K. So in the equilibrium position of the total mass, M1 plus M2. Again, net force on the total on the mass M1 plus M2 is zero. That means the magnitude of the elastic force by spring can be turned K into X2, which acts upwards, balances the weight of the total mass M1 plus M2. That is KX2 can be now M1 plus M2 into G in magnitude. So X2 can be written as M1 plus M2 into G by K. That means when the total mass M1 plus M2 is in equilibrium, the elongation of spring is X2 and the mass M2 is removed gently from one side at the instant when the total mass M1 plus M2 is originally at rest in the equilibrium position. So at this, if you consider the instant just after the mass M2 is removed, the magnitude of the elastic force by spring in the upward direction is K into X2. Because the elongation of spring is X2. If you consider the instant just after the mass M2 is removed, the elongation of spring is X2. And magnitude of the elastic force by spring is KX2, which is equal to M1 plus M2 into G, which will be more than M1G. That means at the instant just after the mass M2 is removed, the net force on M1 will be directed upwards. So therefore the mass M1 starts moving upwards from this position. That means at the instant just after the mass M2 is removed, M1 starts moving upwards from rest. That means zero initial velocity. So this position can be taken as, that is the initial position of M1 at the instant just after M2 is removed, can be taken as one of the extreme positions of mass M1 after M2 is removed. And the right hand side I have shown the equilibrium position of the mass M1 during oscillations of the mass M1 after M2 is removed. That means this is the mean position for oscillations of mass M1 on the right hand side. Distance between the mean position and one of the extreme positions will be equal to the magnitude of the displacement amplitude. You can observe from the figure the vertical distance, the longest spring in the equilibrium position of mass M1 is X1. The longest spring in the initial position of mass M1, at the instant just after M2 is removed, is X2. So distance between the equilibrium position of M1 and one of the extreme positions of the mass M1 now during its oscillations after M2 is removed is equal to magnitude of displacement amplitude. So you can observe from the figure that x1 plus a will be equal to x2. So a plus x1 can be written as x2. So amplitude of oscillation of mass m1 after m2 is removed can be written as x2 minus x1. That is m1 plus m2 into g by k minus m1 g by k. You can, if you simplify this, you get magnitude of the displacement amplitude for oscillations of the mass m1 after m2 is removed. You can write a equal m2 g by k. So in short, for problems based on this case, you can take magnitude of the displacement amplitude of the remaining mass of the system when a part of the mass of the system is removed from the equilibrium position of the original system. Can be written as weight, magnitude of the weight removed. Divided by elastic force kinetic of spring. Of course, once mass m2 is removed, the time period of oscillations of the mass m1 after m2 is removed can be found by using the same result which I have discussed in the past. That is time period of vertical oscillations of mass m suspended by elastic force constraint is given by 2 pi root of m by k. Here m should be taken as equal to m1. Now I would like to show you the notes for this case 2 which I have just discussed now. Now you can get ready with your notebook and pen to write the notes which I am going to show on the screen. First I will be showing you the conclusion. Later I will show the working for the conclusion. So come on, look at the screen. First I am going to read out the conclusion for case 2 which I have just discussed now. Later I will show you the working for the conclusion. Consider a system of two masses suspended by an ideal spring of force constant K. So two masses M1 and M2. You can write M1 and M2 here. Suspended an ideal spring of force constant K which are initially at rest in the equilibrium position as shown in the figure. I will show the figure in my next slide. Mass M2 is gently removed from a side. Then the amplitude of oscillation resulting SSM is given by. So those who are writing the notes, they can take a pause and finish writing the notes. So next I am going to show the conclusion, working for this conclusion along with this diagram. So this is the diagram here. In this diagram I have shown the equilibrium position of total mass m1 plus m2 here at the lowest position. L0 is the natural length of spring, that is the length of spring when it is not stretched and not compressed. The upper end of spring is connected to rigid support. X1 is the elongation of spring in the equilibrium position of the mass M1 and X2 is the elongation of spring in the equilibrium position of total mass M1 plus M2. So as I already explained to the working, now we can copy the working from the screen. Once read out in equilibrium position of mass M1 plus M2, Kx2 equal M1 plus M2G in magnitude. Or x2 equal to m1 plus m2 into whole multiplied by g by k. In the equilibrium position of mass m1, can write net force on M1 is 0 are explained KX1 equal M1G in magnitude or X1 equal M1G1. So those are writing the notes, come and take a pause and finish writing the notes up to this step including the diagram. So next I am going to show the work continuation for this. In the figure I have shown here, x1 plus a is x2, or a equal x2 minus x1. Then substituting x2 and x1, you get a equal m2g by k or a equal weight removed by k. So come on, take a pause and finish writing the working. Next I am going to discuss one more special case, case 3. So next case I am going to discuss case 3. This is actually related also to the theory of elasticity. So it will be better to go through this case in case you are already familiar with the basic formula for Young's model of elasticity. Otherwise you can go through this case after you have finished elasticity. Let us consider elastic force constant. We are going to discuss the calculation of elastic force constant of an elastic metallic wire. The thickness of metal wire may not be as much as shown in the figure. Let us consider elastic metallic wire, for example, like steel, whose Young's modulus is Y, original area of cross section is A, and natural length is L0. So when a mass M is suspended from the lower end, the delta L with elongation of the wire in the equilibrium of the mass. So magnitude of the elastic force by the spring, by the string on the mass, you can write K times delta L, I mean in the equilibrium position. Delta L is the elongation of the elastic metal wire in the equilibrium position of suspended mass. F is the magnitude of elastic force by the string, of course, which is the balance of the weight of suspended mass in the equilibrium position. So, on the theory of elasticity, Young's modulus of elasticity is equal to tensile stress divided by longitudinal strain. Tensile stress is equal to magnitude of the tensional force acting normal to unit area of cross section of the wire, and longitudinal strain is equal to delta L by L, or can I write FL by A into delta L. So you can substitute F equal to K into delta L on the numerator, right side. So you get Y equal to K into L by A, should write L naught, that means natural length. So elastic force constant of the metallic wire is given by Y A by K, I mean Y A by L naught. So elastic force constant of these elastic metal wire, the Young's modulus Y and original length L naught, I mean unstretched length L naught and original area of cross section A, can be written as Y A by L naught. So I would like to show the working for same case. First I am directly shown the conclusion on screen. I will once read out the conclusion on screen for case 3. Those who are writing the notes, they can write this conclusion. The elastic force constant of uniform metal wire of natural length L naught, original area of cross section, original cross section area A, and X modulus capital Y is given by K equal Y A by L naught. If you want to copy the conclusion, take a pause and copy the conclusion. I'd like to show the little working I have discussed for this conclusion. In small velocity, can write F by A divided by XE by L naught. Instead of delta L, I have written XE for elongation of the equilibrium position. In equilibrium position, you can write F equal to K into XE. So if you substitute f equal to k into xe here, you get y equal to kx e into l naught by a into xe. So those who are copying the notes, take a pause and finish writing the notes up to this step. Next, I would like to show the continuation. Y equal to kl naught by a or k equal to y a by l naught. The thickness of small oscillations, mass m suspended by the wire is given by the formula 1 by t or 1 by 2 find root of k by m. And take a pause and finish copying the working up to here. So I will continue my discussion next class. Next class I will be discussing about combinations of springs, springs in parallel and springs in series.